World leaders are participating Thursday in a UN General Assembly high-level meeting on non-communicable diseases, the world's leading killers. The diseases include childhood cancer, which affects around 300,000 children and adolescents worldwide each year. Approximately 80% of children in high-income countries survive the disease, but only about 20% in low- and middle-income countries. Africa 54 health correspondent Ina Madu spoke to Dr. Etienne Krug, director of the World Health Organization's Department for Management of Non-Communicable Diseases, Disability, Violence and Injury Prevention. He discusses the scope of the problem and the WHO's new global initiative for childhood cancer launched during the UNGA.
Childhood cancer epitomizes inequity. There are about 300,000 new cases of childhood cancer, children developing cancer every year in the world. If a child develops a cancer in a rich country, it has an 80% chance of survival. The same child in a poor country with the same cancer would have a 20% only chance of survival. So it's a big inequity issue, and it shouldn't be. We know what needs to be done. We need to diagnose. Prevention is very hard for childhood cancer, but we need to diagnose it early and treat it, make sure people have access to medicines, that they are not too expensive, and that, you know, the whole treatment is followed. We can do that. In rich countries, it's already happening, but we can also do that in the poorer countries. This is why WHO this week is launching a new initiative, the Childhood Cancer Initiative, to scale up treatment for all children around the world and make sure that all of them have access to the treatment they need. Thereby, we can save millions of lives.
One of the challenges with childhood cancer is the fact that we don't really know the causes. So how do we even start talking about prevention, for example?
Yeah, right now we need to do more research to really understand where do these childhood cancers come from, because we know very little about the causes of childhood cancer. But we know what needs to be done to detect and treat them. Mm-hmm. And we can save most of these children. So for now, we need to invest in research to find out the causes and prevent. But in the meanwhile, make sure every child gets diagnosed on time and treated.
So this initiative that will be launched this week by the WHO, how much money are we talking about? Who are the different parties that are involved?
We're partnering with many different agencies for this initiative, but one key agency is the St. Jude Children's Hospital, who's providing $15 million for a five-year kickoff of this program, which will help us scale up programs in many countries, you know, do capacity building and training of staff, set up centers of excellence where children can be referred to, improve the access to medicines. That's what we're going to focus on. And at the same time, you know, do advocacy and communication and awareness raising about the importance of dealing with this issue and about the symptoms and how to detect it and how to react to it.
And how many countries are we talking about and regions?
We'll start immediately in all regions of the world with 6 countries, and then we'll gradually scale up to 18 countries as a start. We hope to expand to all countries, really, over the years to come.
And African countries?
Of course.
Yes. And when we talk about Africa with childhood cancer, and it's not just childhood cancer, a lot of conditions that people do not understand, unfortunately, tend to be linked to some cultural beliefs. Mm-hmm. And childhood cancer, because we don't know the causes, sometimes parents feel like either it's a bad luck or bad omen or something of that nature. So how much of this new initiative will include education and awareness, especially in sub-Saharan Africa?
I've worked as a doctor in Mozambique for several years. I've seen how many beliefs there can be around diseases that we don't necessarily understand, and how much time can be lost because of, you know, lack of understanding of the importance to consult with the medical system and to try to get a diagnosis and treatment as soon as possible. Mm-hmm. For all diseases, but especially also for childhood cancer. So we will try to dispel some of the myths around childhood cancer. We'll try to educate the public in general about the need to consult as soon as possible, as soon as the symptoms start arising.
What is your message then when it comes to childhood cancer, especially to the research community?
For the research community, we need to continue, of course, working on additional treatment and cheaper treatments, but there's already a lot we can do with what we have, but particularly focus on what are the causes in order to be able to prevent these things better.
And finally, when we look to the Sustainable Development Goals, and non-communicable diseases seem not to be doing so much in terms of attaining them, what are your thoughts?
There are a lot of efforts going on, but the goal 3.4 of reducing by 30% the premature mortality of NCDs by 2030 is very ambitious. We can reach it. We know enough about what needs to be done to reach it, but we need to dramatically scale up our efforts. Heads of states need to take the lead to have an all-of-government approach, and the best buys that WHO has identified as the most cost-effective interventions need to be implemented in all countries.
Dr. Etienne Krug, thank you so much.